Story, another 3 weeks after Sheena murder mystery erupted, Mumbai police has made a major breakthrough in the case. Police Commissioner Rakesh Maria confirmed last night that the remains recovered from Raigad crime scene belonged to Sheena Bora, saying that the DNA samples conclusively matched those of her parents. And adding to the list of clues, cops have managed to recover the shoes worn by Sanjeev Khanna when he travelled to Raigad to dispose of Sheena's body. Furthermore, police have retrieved Sheena's jewellery from Sanjeev Khanna's house in Kolkata. Meanwhile, a day after Indrani was sent to 14 days judicial custody, police will produce Khanna in Bandra court today.
We have received the DNA report from the FSL, and the DNA report states that it is conclusively proved that the accused Indrani Mukherjee is the biological mother of the deceased. In addition to that, our team had taken the second accused, Khanna, to Kolkata. He led us to the spot where we have recovered the shoes which were used by the accused when they went to dump the body at Penn. In addition to that, we have recovered part of the jewellery of the deceased Sheena also.
All right, for more on this story, let's go across to Vidya, who joins us. Morning, Vidya. Now, the police commissioner, Rakesh Maria, has very categorically mentioned that they have received or got some clinching evidence which perhaps, you know, fit the missing pieces of the jigsaw puzzle called the Sheena murder mystery. But how watertight is their case really? Because that's exactly the essence of this particular, murder mystery. How watertight will the police's case actually going to be? The point that you were making yesterday.
Sanket, Mumbai police's case certainly seems to be harboring more on the forensic. The fact that, they've collected shoes which might have those three-year-old, soil on them that they can probably connect to Raigad from Indrani's shoes as well. This kind of soil is being collected so that this connection, the fact that they did go to Raigad wearing those shoes and sandals, and that's the reason why their shoes and sandals have those kind of soil on them. That's very minute forensic and laboratory tests that are being done, that will be done on these, and that's the reason why Mumbai police had taken Sanjeev Khanna. And now with all these collection of all these evidences together, Mumbai police is very confident that they will have a watertight case against Indrani and will prove that it was they themselves who had taken Sheena's body and dumped it in Raigad, trying to dispose it off, trying to waste the entire evidence. So certainly Mumbai police is very sure, but it will ultimately have to depend on the kind of charge sheet that they put across. They have approximately 90 days, but Mr. Maria has been promising that the charge sheet will be filed much earlier with the clinching evidences that they have. With all that, we surely expect that soon we'll get to know what exactly Absolutely. Is further in the entire story that Mumbai police has, and if it has really got the motive as of now.
Absolutely, absolutely. It'll be interesting to see what really the Mumbai police actually puts in that charge sheet, because that is going to be, the real clincher, whether the case that has been built based on the investigation that has been conducted is watertight or not, because the Mumbai police insist that it will make sure that this there are no loose ends. But Vidya, another thing that we wanted to know is, has there been any word on this press conference yesterday by Rakesh Maria, by, say, for instance, the the defense lawyers or lawyers of Indrani as well as Mr. Sanjeev Khanna? Have they said something?
With regards to Indrani, certainly, they will be filing a bail application as soon as they prepare their defense. They need to put up a strong defense to see to it that before the charge sheet is filed, they get bail for Indrani. But as far as Sanjeev Khanna's lawyers are concerned, they are quite adamant for the fact that Sanjeev Khanna, who was supposed to be presented in court yesterday, but he was taken all the way to West Bengal. The Mumbai police tried to produce him in West Bengal in the Alipur court, but the magistrate there refused to take his remand for the simple reason that there was no prior communication. since he was not produced there, he was not produced in the court today, so there is no production of Sanjeev Khanna, which basically means that this is an illegal detention according to his lawyers, and that's the reason they will press for the fact that whatever has been collected as material evidence from Sanjeev Khanna during this illegal detention, that should not really be considered. And that's the one thing that they are going to press for in court today when Sanjeev Khanna will be presented at the
what
Bandra
time?
Court by Mumbai Police.
What time, Vidya? Very
well,
brief.
It's expected that Sanket around 3 o'clock,
okay.
You know, the most probably the remand production is done. So it is expected that they will be bringing Sanjeev Khanna around that time as well.
Vidya, many thanks for joining us with all the latest. This is one case where the Mumbai police now feels that it is closer to clinching evidence. It has shifted its focus now to the money trail and the motive, as Vidya was pointing out. Police is now scanning the flow of funds between Indrani Mukherjee, her former husband Sanjeev Khanna, and driver Shyam Rai. It is alleged that the driver was paid 1.5 lakh rupees in 3 installments for his part in the murder. For this, a special team has been formed by the Economic Offences Wing of the Mumbai Police. Another front in the economic trail is the probe into Indrani and her current husband Peter Mukherjee's loss-making companies. According to sources, several fake transactions have been traced to Kolkata, and police suspect the role of Sanjeev Khanna in allegedly laundering money. The fake companies were reportedly formed to hide Indrani and Peter Mukherjee's finances and sold to fake individuals allegedly in Kolkata. In fact, Sanjeev Khanna was taken to Kolkata yesterday to reportedly follow this lead.
Income tax consultants and our economic offence wing officers, this team has been working on studying the various companies, the various investments, the various properties, not only in India but also in the UK, in Spain, in various parts of India belonging to the Mukherjees as well as the companies owned by them.